Hi friends, Chandrasekhar here again. We are into the 33rd lecture on interpretation of Jaimini Sutras, or rather my perspective of what they mean. As I never forget to tell, I have no great authority on that, but this is Sutra, it is said that Alpaksharam Asandigdam Saravat. So it is extract of something which has a particular thread running through the argument, and it breaks at some time, something else comes. So you have to read them in order to understand what is being said. This is the general concept when we talk about sutras, and that is why they are difficult to interpret, open to many interpretations. So what we have seen earlier was, we saw that, you know, when malefics aspect the third house, then what happens? Karmani pape, pape yute drushteva, dushtamaranam. So we know that aspects on the third house can indicate how a person will die. Then we went on ahead and found out what planets can create what sort of diseases which that gentleman, the Jataka, might contract. And so the last one sutra was Shukrena Mehat. So urinary infections, even sometimes perhaps diabetes, not sure. I would give diabetes more to Jupiter. But so Meha means urinary infections generally. Some have interpreted it as diabetes also, because there is a lot of passage of urine during diabetes. So now, having given different planets, what is said next is Mishre Mishrat. This is no brainer, you know. Obviously, if not a single planet is not there, then there will be two planets. When both the indications of those planets will merge together and give some other disease. So this is not something very great to understand. Saturn, you know, is connected with breathing. Besides Vata Roga, as it is said, so arthritis, etc. And if it is connected with Moon, whose aspect can give Yakshmanaha, that is the disease of tuberculosis, then Saturn there will certainly give it. So what is next said is Chandra Druk Yoga Nishchayane. If Moon is aspecting or occupying the third bhava, when whatever diseases are shown by the planet or combination of planets will certainly occur. Whether a person will die or not, we think about it, because there are so many things involved. One doesn't die at the moment, you know, one is born. So obviously dashas would be important, the transits would be important. We have seen it somewhere else when I gave my opinion about when a person might die. And then what he said is Shubhe Shubhadeshe. If benefits are there, then he dies in a good country. Which to me would mean perhaps his own country or in his own culture. Because one always thinks that one's own culture is a Shubha, is auspicious, and others is inauspicious. And then he says, Pape hi Kikate. Kikate Desha is generally, Kikate country is generally considered to be Magadha, the what is now called Bihar in India, which was many a times, you know, a country which though had very great intellects, also had rogues. So, in a country of different culture is what I would understand from it. Now, what does this refer to? I think this Shubhe Shubhadesha refers to aspect of benefic planets or malefic planet on the third house. And that is perhaps has to do with the Dushta Maranam, which is also talked about. Karmani Papa Yute Drushte, etc. etc. It could also mean that this is referring to aspect of Moon, and then aspect of a benefic or malefic on the third bhava. Karmani is three, you know that. Next is said, Guru Shukrabhyam Jnana Purvakam. Now here, two benefics aspecting the third house would give, the person would be well aware that his time has now come. Some interpret it as he has prescience of death and passes away very painlessly, and there are different ways you interpret what is jnana purvakam. It can be I am in great trouble and die, but since this is benefic and the reference is to shubhe shubhadeshe etc. And earlier also we see that if benefic's aspect, then the death is auspicious, meaning you are aware of it and so you are not in under coma or no serious problems. This is what is, this is how I would look at it. Anyara anyatha, if other planets are there, then that person might not be aware that he is going to die. So what do we do with Guru and Shukra? Suppose Moon is also with him, then what happens is to be thought of. I think any benefic aspect would make that person at least not be under coma when he passes away, to that extent, because ultimately death, nobody likes death. As I say, that is why I am not going into the Rudra, Maheshwara and other things, Brahma etc., the Maraka planets and other things which are dwelt upon at length in Jaimini Sutra. I am not interested, I have made it clear, so please don't expect me either to comment on it or to explain it to you, or even the dashas, I would not want to explain. There are too many dashas. Then, after this, what he said is, Lena Leya Janakayor Madhe Shani Rahu Ketu Bhi Pitrorna Samskarta. Now, some have taken it as Janaka, I think, in. B. Surya Narayana's commentary, he has, instead of Janaka, he takes Kapa. But the meaning is simple. Leya means one, and Janaka in Katapayadi is 12. So mostly what is what it is interpreted as is, if Saturn, Rahu and Ketu, of course it means Saturn and Rahu or Saturn and Ketu. Ketu and Rahu cannot be at one place, you know that. They are always diametrically opposite, placed in diametrically opposite Rashis or Bhavas, whatever you consider, because in Jaimini, Rashi and Bhavas are correct, I mean, considered almost at par. So what is being said is, this is interpreted that if between 1st house and 12th house, Shani, Rahu and Ketu are there, then the person will not perform the last rites of the father. This to me doesn't seem very logical, because they will always be between 1st and 12th house, isn't it? I mean, then they say Leyadi Purvardhe Janakadya Parardhe. That means if it is between 1 and 6, that is how it is interpreted. And if it is from 7 to 12th, then alternately, for mother and for father, he will not perform the last rites. This is the interpretation. Please wait till this is over, because I want to make it. This will be a short lecture. I would want to keep it short. I don't know how long I can go on talking, but I think it might be short. And then Shubhadruga Yogarno, as usual. Whenever benefic aspect, this would not happen. That is a standard thing which comes up every time in Jaimini. And please remember this. The problem is, many a times people take yogas literally without considering that if there is a benefic aspect or benefic conjunction at a particular place, those things, the negatives would not happen, or at least happen on a lower scale. Never forget this. Again, what we understand from Jaimini, whenever Moon is also aspecting a place of where some yoga is being told, something is going to happen, that will certainly happen. Perhaps that has to do with it, because the mind of the person will also be wanting to do whatever is being shown by that particular yoga. The combination of planets, they indicate something we have seen at many places. I mean, like Guru Shukra Abhyam Dhyana Purvakam etc. etc. or Shukrena Mehat, isn't it? So, will it certainly happen if Moon is looking? Yes, certainly happen. What it means is, whatever is needed to get that sort of disease, that person is bound to do. Because his mind, Moon represents mind, Manasa, as it is called. And We also seen moon and mandi together can give those illusions of possession or actual possession. I am not very sure about possessions. I am not a master on that. Yeah, but some people do believe that you are possessed by spirits, and Chandra Mandi has that combination. So mind, it is all in mind, isn't it? Or erratic behavior, all those things will always come to the fore when moon has some malefic influence. What sort would depend on the planet. So this has to be, this is the essence of, let us say, Jaimini Sutras, that when moon aspects a particular combination, that thing is bound to happen. Whatever is indicated, it may be good, bad, ugly, is immaterial. And when we consider the Jaimini Sutra part of it, then always think about the Rashi Drushtis, because that is what when he explains at length, as he has said earlier, Upadesham Vakhyasam. Now I am telling you, I am defining something, obviously more clearly. So in sutras you don't have to go on talking at length, as I am talking to you. Sutras are very brief. So now the question is, Leyadi Purvardhe means 1 to 6, between that if Shani and Rahu is there, or Ketu is there, because Ketu is always opposite Saturn and Rahu, Rahu, or Saturn or Ketu are between 1 and 6, Ketu will always be on the opposite side. So between 1 and 6, if Shani and Rahu or Shani or Ketu are there, then one will not perform, you know, the last rites of mother. And if on the other side, then of father. Now this doesn't appeal to my sense of logic at least. Because original sutra is Le Janaka Yor Madhe Shani Rahu Ketur Bhi Pitrorna Sauskarta. Now from 1 to 12, all these planets will always be there. I mean, whatever way you look at it. And since that is there, one will never perform last rites of a father. That is impossible. So, my understanding is, this Janaka Yor Madhe is not to be interpreted in Katapayadi system of that, because it makes 108 divided by 12 is 0. So 12, that is how it is considered. But I am looking at this chapter's first sutra, which if you remember is something like Ravi Shukrayo Prani Janaka. Between Ravi and Venus, whosoever is stronger is indicative of father, and Chandra Aryo Janani, between Moon and Mars, whoever is stronger indicates mother. This is talking about that. And now what this means is Leya and Janaka Yor Madhe means the Lagna and the Karaka for mother, wherever he is placed, between them, if Saturn and Rahu or Saturn and Ketu are placed, then that person might not perform the last rites of the mother. And if between the Lagna and the Karaka for father, the strongest among Sun or Venus, as is told by the Prani is strength, so by the sage, if between that these two planets are there, it will be either Shani and Rahu or Shani and Ketu. Please remember this, because Ketu is always opposite Saturn. So, if we interpret it literally, then Shani, Rahu, Ketu, Bhi means all three together. No, it is not so. So, then he might not perform the last rites of the father. This appeals to reason. This is also a possible thing which is possible to happen. Otherwise, either Saturn and Rahu will be between, or Saturn and Ketu will be between 1st and 6th house, or 6th and 12th house. So that person is bound to not perform the last rites of either mother or father. This doesn't happen. Not at least in India, but even in other countries, whatever is the system disposing of the body is a very bad way of expressing it, but giving the last rites to the person who is departed. How many sons are there who would not do for any of them? There can be a few numbers. I understand. This is a science of numbers. I think you might be tired of listening. I always say this is a science of probability. Sambhavanaon ka shastra hai, sambhavanaon ka. Sambhavana means possibilities in Hindi. That is how I express it. And those sambhavanas or those possibilities are brought into actual being by the karma of the jataka. And as you know, as we were discussing earlier, aspect of moon will make it a certainty that it will happen. So I think this is how it should be interpreted. Of course, the great translators have interpreted it in different manner. Everybody has his view. Most of them have interpreted this three sutras, that is the, I think, 29th and 13th or something like that. Those sutras are interpreted in the that from 1 to 6, they should be Purvardha is 1 to 6, because that is when the sun has not arisen, and Parardha is, 7 to 12. But I think that is wrong interpretation. The learned amongst my subscribers, and most of them are learned, nobody otherwise would go in for such a tedious subject as astrology, and would go on listening to me, who speaks at length many a times, maybe sometimes trying your patience. Try that out on real life chart, maybe even your own chart or anybody whom you know, and find out whether I am right or wrong. Otherwise, most of the places you will find that nobody would perform last rites of their parents. This doesn't happen. And that is why I think it is, you first find out who is strongest of the Sun and Venus. Take it as the Karaka for father, and see from Lagna to that Karaka is in between those two, Shani, Rahu, or I mean Saturn and Rahu, if I am saying Shani all the way, you see, being multilingual makes always a problem. So Saturn and Rahu or Saturn or Ketu are there, and he has not performed for reason. I mean, it's not that he has not deliberately performed. Maybe that person is living at some other place where his father passes away and comes to know of it later on. That is quite possible. So look at it and then decide. As I always say, that Mata Bhede Muni Naam Tu is a shloka. Jyotishe Vaidike Tatha. What they say is, if there is a difference of opinion between the sages, I am no Muni, don't worry, I am not calling myself Muni. I am talking about the great translators like Lashan Lal Jha, Achyutananda Jha, Sitaram Jha, Pandit B. Surya Narayan Rao, Pandit Sanjay Rath, K.N. Rao Sahab, and many more. Because many young scholars are coming up, they also have their own opinion. But to me, it doesn't make sense if it is between 1 to 6 or say 1 to 12. They will be somewhere there only. They can't be anywhere else. Whichever way you look at it, they have to be between that. I mean, this is just common sense. Look at a chart and you will realize what I am saying. And so, my dear friends, I will take your leave. I am sure you will be happy that I am finishing off within my self-imposed limit of 16 minutes. Two reasons. This is a complex thing which I wanted to explain. Other things, Mishra, Mishra, if they are a combination of planets, there will be a combination of diseases, is relatively easy to understand. For people as intelligent as you, I don't need to explain that. I wanted to talk about Chandra, Drug Yoga, Nishchayana. This is one, that whenever any yoga, if moon is either in that yoga or aspecting that yoga, certain the things indicated will certainly happen, is what the sage is taking, really. And here, that Leya Janaka Yor Madhe, that Janaka need not be translated into Katapayadi, because it is talking about a particular Karaka. Sarvatra Savarna Bhava Rasha Yashcha. About Bhava and Rashis, you take into consideration the Katapayadi. That is what was the injunction of the great Jaimini in the first chapter itself. So don't remember, forget that, okay? And this is, I think here I'll perhaps stop the. I'm not sure. I'll go through and then tell you. This is the second pada of the second chapter. Third and fourth, I'll find out if there are certain sutras which are interesting and which can be applied anywhere, whether in the regular I prefer to call traditional system of astrology, or most of the people call it Parashari astrology. For me, astrology is only one. The tradition, even Jaimini, is also traditional. It is a viewpoint is different. That's all. So, my dear friends, I'll find out. Today I am finishing. I am also a bit off color today. So, I'll take your leave. And do keep letting me know at whatever point you think this is getting too boring. Let me know. So, then I'll shift to some other subject. But I intend to find out some aphorisms which might help you in interpretation of charts. And I would like to see aphorisms which can be applied universally rather than only to X part or Y part. And this is my idiosyncrasy, you will pardon me. So my dear friends, a very good night. And thank you very much.